we have this wonderful plan going forward to help everyone wake up to the realization of what their best option is, which is to realize that they can stop pretending to be human, to be in a world, to be suffering, to be vulnerable. So we have a plan to help everyone in the world do that. It was a very great day announcing this plan. Finally, we get to know truth after wallowing in self-deceit for so long, thinking that we're humans, human beings, and that we have to do something to increase our standing somehow in reality, and that we can somehow lose our standing in reality, all the feelings of guilt and despair and depression and all these hideous mental sufferings that go along with the false belief that we're human. We're pretending to be something other than what we truly are, and we can stop that pretending. So this is the global initiative for this planet, the big boost that we spend the next, let's say 15 years, why not say that? For everyone to realize that we're only dreaming this nightmare, and we can wake up. Now, it's so cut and dried, and so black and white, and so obvious that it's a little bit odd that we have to explain it, but I guess we do. So maybe that's what the Pope is here in the United States. He's the ex-Pope Emeritus Francis is here in Washington, D.C., meeting with the POTUS, the MOTUS, on 23rd of September. Then addressing the joint session of Congress on the 24th. And then on the 25th, the President is going to address the the full assembly of the United Nations, because they're kicking off this huge, biggest launch in history, guess Sustainable Development Goal conference, where every single leader of every nation that's a member of the United Nations, which is almost every nation, I think there's a couple that are not, are going to sign a commitment. They're going to sign a commitment. Every single leader in the world is going to sign a commitment to commit to a 15-year plan. Oh, that's great. So the Pope is going to address the UN General Assembly to kick off this historic, all-important, greatest, most important conference in history, where they're going to sign on to a 15-year plan. They've already agreed upon it. So what is this, a plan for enlightenment? Where we're going to work on right spiritual practice to lead us to realizing that we're not a victim of anything whatsoever. It's impossible to be victimized. Forgiving ourselves for believing that we could be victimized, and realizing that we're completely sovereigns in charge of all our own experiencing, that we all have perfect standing in God. Oh, wait a minute. Is that what the Pope's here for? Actually not. The Pope is here to kick off the Sustainable Development Goals plan, a 15-year plan. Now, here's a video that has been produced to promote the United Nations SDGs, Sustainable Development Goals. And this is on YouTube. It's about a minute and 17 second video. I'm going to give you the transcript of this. This is what the Pope is here to kick off. It says, this is a voiceover. Hello, everyone. On September 25th, every single United Nations world leader is going to sign up to 17 global goals for sustainable development. In the next 15 years, we plan to achieve some extraordinary things. End extreme poverty, fight inequality and injustice, tackle climate change, and we want everyone's help. Every single person on the planet. I guess that means you and me, right? I guess they're talking about you and me. Interesting. We want to tell everyone about these great global goals. This to-do list for people and planet Everyone needs to know that we have a plan. 7 billion people in 7 days. Let's give these global goals the biggest launch in history to make history happen. And you can help us. Tell everyone we have a plan. Now I'll read it again more quickly. Voiceover saying this. Hello everyone. On September 25th, every single United Nations world leader is going to sign up to 17 global goals for sustainable development. In the next 15 years, we plan to achieve some extraordinary things: end extreme poverty, fight inequality and injustice, tackle climate change. And we want everyone's help. Every single person on the planet. We want to tell everyone about these great global goals. This to-do list for people and planet. Everyone needs to know that we have a plan. 7 billion people in 7 days. Let's give these global goals the biggest launch in history to make history happen. And you can help us. Tell everyone we have a plan. Now, what was it, a week and a half ago or so, Google was promoting this video, Human, which I pointed out. And this is what Google says. A new film about every single one of us, human. Or human. A new film about every single one of us. Every single one of us. Now look at this United Nations rollout. Sustainable Development Goals, SDG. Hello, everyone. So there's the term everyone. Google has about every single one of us. Hello, everyone. Every single United Nations world leader. And we want everyone's help. There's everyone, every single, everyone, every single, everyone. Every single person on the planet. There we go. We want to tell everyone. Okay. Everyone needs to listen to know we have a plan. There's everyone again. 7 billion people, meaning everyone. Tell everyone we have a plan. So everyone, every single, we want everyone, every single, everyone, everyone, 7 billion people. You, okay, and tell everyone, 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 every single one, everyone, everyone. Human, I knew a film about every single one of us. Coincidence that Google put this out and is promoting Human? I don't think so. Do we think so? This is exactly what the Holy Spirit's been warning us about. Great, great confirmation. This is what's going on. The Sustainable Development Goal Conference of the United Nations is literally a 15-year plan that has already been drawn up and drafted, with every single world leader signing on to this. And the purpose, and they say, we have a plan for your future. This is a global plan for your future. And your leaders have signed up. Leaders? I don't know. Did Jesus sign up on this? Ramana Maharshi, Anandamayi Ma, Longchenpa, they signed up on this? God, Holy Spirit? I don't know. Is the Holy Spirit a signatory to the United Nations? Is there a seat in the United Nations for the Holy Spirit? I thought the Holy Spirit was our leader. So they have a 15-year plan that's already been drafted, and the details have been being worked out and solidified, and it's going to be formalized here, which is why I said this week's the most important week in history, because they're trying to shoehorn us into their future, their humanistic future, which is an abomination, to say the least. It is the worst option possible. They're picking the worst option possible. There's two options. Either we try to make pretense permanent, or we decide to gently set pretense aside. That's it. There isn't any other option we have. So what they're saying is, we're all in. And they keep saying they're speaking for everyone. Really? I thought the Holy Spirit spoke for everyone. Because the Holy Spirit has a plan to help every single one of us set pretense down. In fact, it's already been accomplished. The Holy Spirit has already worked the entire thing out so that it's seen that it's all accomplished, already accomplished for everyone. That's the plan I want. That's the plan that's already for everyone. So here we have the other shoe dropping now. We already know the Pope and the President are both going to go around their constituencies. The Pope's main obstacle is the bishops, and he's going to use the President of the United Nations to help him get around that for this 15-year global development plan. And the President's biggest obstacle is Congress, and he's going to use the Pope to help get around Congress and give him a moral authority to do so. So when he signs executive order, executive order, executive order, and maybe suspends the elections coming up, etc., the Pope will say, oh, that's my guy, man. That's okay. You know, we got important goals to deal with here. We got global goals, global sustainable development goals. And so they think they've decided for everybody. So whoa, not so fast. We already have, the Holy Spirit already has its plan. This trumps the UN's plan. So the UN is late to the party. You know, they're party crashers. They're trying to crash the party. They're not crashing our party. No way. No way in the world they're crashing our party. Holy Spirit's throwing a party. I'm even going to grill some bloomin' onions today. I got this, cleaned the grill up and got this bloomin' onion thing and I've got it ready to go. I've got put olive oil on it, ground up some pepper and salt, some other all-purpose seasoning and some balsamic vinegar, and I'm going to grill that onion. It's a sweet white onion, and then put some dip in the middle of it, and wow, away we go. So yeah, these party crashers are signed a declaration they're going to crash the Holy Spirit's parties. No, they're not. Well, there may be a lot of wailing and gnashing of teeth. Well, maybe. Rending of garments, perhaps. But they're not crashing the Holy Spirit's party at all. So this is what I'm here for, to reassure you about this, okay? Because this is really, they're trying to throw a gut punch at us. Catch you by surprise. Well, we're not caught by surprise. The Holy Spirit told me to stay home right now and dig into this, which I did. So there's something important you need to really look at. Oh, wow, the SDG, Sustainable Development Goal Conference. Planned, 15-year plan for the globe, for the planet, for every one of us, every single one of us. Tell everyone, you know, in 7 days you want to contact 7 billion people. I said, remember in the last couple of videos, that this is, there's going to be the biggest marketing and campaign take place in the next 9 months. And by that end of those 9 months, by June 21st, 2016, there will be this global consensus that the people of the world have agreed to this 15-year plan. This is what's going to happen. This is the Holy Spirit told me. Basically, they say, we're after 15 years, we're going to crash the Holy Spirit's party. No, they're not. They're not ever going to crash it. The party's already over. It's all done and finished. But we're honoring the memory of this great success by the Holy Spirit by celebrating, absolutely. The Holy Spirit has actually led every single one of us to awakening. It's already finished. The Holy Spirit has already finished. From the very beginning, the entire end was clear. All accomplished like that. So we're just honoring our creativity, the creativity involved in this. And but they're not going to crash our party, plain and simple. I have to put somebody at a door, a bouncer, you know, at the door. You got some good candidates. Do you have an invitation here? You're here to crash the party? No party crashers here, sorry. So we have not been caught unawares. We had the outline very clear. And now the details get filled in. There's 17 goals they have. 17 goals. Global goals. They've decided these goals for us, they think. But and nowhere in those 17 goals do I hear anything about the Holy Spirit, about a vision of oneness, about right spiritual practice, about choosing the option of setting aside pretense, about the intermediate step, about the Holy Spirit, about the various great spiritual teachers helping this plan along, these goals along, about recognizing repentance? Is repentance of 7 billion people, is that a goal? I think in the 17, do I see the goal in 15 years is for everyone to repent on this planet? I didn't notice that goal there for some reason. Maybe the Pope forgot to put it in there. Ex-Pope. Excommunicated Pope. Hopefully some of the bishops start excommunicating him. And say, well, wait for the true Pope to show up. Actually, the true Pope has already shown up. Jesus is already back. So it's a moot point. The Pope is no longer the Pope, actually. Which is why he's not acting like a Pope. It's all good. I mean, this is why they elected this guy in the first place. Because his whole role was to stop being the Pope. Because Jesus is already back. Came back in the conjunction of April and May. And he hasn't surfaced yet in ways that most people recognize, but he's already here. That means the papacy is ended. So the Pope is no longer the Pope, actually. You could say the President is no longer the President, also. In some ways you could say this, because Jesus really is in charge of the plan of redemption for all of us. Meaning, the plan of redemption is simply to help us realize that everyone has equal standing in God. This is ultimately the goal. And we can never lose that perfect standing. It's completely impossible. Everyone has equal standing with God, and God is all there is. So we have absolutely immaculate, perfect standing and perfect inclusivity, the one spiritual family. We can never lose this or have it diminished in the slightest bit. This is the goal that, you know, all religious endeavor is aimed at ultimately. It's just that this world, the purpose of this world is to blind us to this goal. So, of course, religion struggles here in this world and is somewhat ragged, and people criticize it a lot because of its raggedness. But keep in mind that this is a place where we spirit goes or imagines itself to be, a dream that it imagines itself to be, that is dedicated to being completely blind to this option of recognizing our true self, the true situation, the one self, that all of us has perfect standing in God. It's dedicated to blinding us to this option. So of course religions struggle here. That doesn't mean we shouldn't be making the effort. We have no choice but to make the effort. So one of the 15, 17 goals should be, we should strive, everybody should strive to make religion even better and more high, perfectly focused upon the true goal that we have. So let's have 7 billion people, very, very religious people in the world, after 15 years, who are dedicated to the true goal of religion, which is to gently set aside all pretense and ultimately accept that we all have perfect standing in God. We can't change that. It's unchangeable. The fact that we have perfect standing in God does not mean that we can, therefore, we're free to change our standing with God. It does not mean that. It means we can't change our standing with God. It's God established it for us. We didn't establish our perfect standing with God for ourselves. Not at all. Not at all. So humanism is designed to try and establish a standing for ourselves. This is insane. It never gets even one step towards this goal. So it seems like these 17 global goals for the next 15 years that the United Nations is going to try to shove down everybody's throat is missing some very, very key goals, wouldn't you say? I mean, we can write up a list of goals too, and I dare say that the United Nations is missing every single one of them. And all the world leaders that are signing off on this. What could be more appalling and shocking than to realize every single leader of every single country in the world is signing off on this? Hello? Does that sound like a world that we would praise? I mean, there's no diversity in this world. I thought that people cherish diversity in this world. And yet every single one of them is agreeing to these goals and signing off on it and agreeing that they're going to together globally tackle these goals intensely. This is supposed to be the most intense effort in history. And they all agree that these goals are should be the primary goals. I mean, everyone, really? This is like beyond shocking. You might say there might be a few countries that would agree with this, but you just mean, that mean they're not some country that are run by intelligent people who would say, wait a minute, these aren't our true goals. So every single leader in the world agrees with this agenda. I guess we're living in an insane asylum. What happened to the diversity? Well, because these nincompoops are schooled in a global education system, which is designed to completely blind them to what their true options really are. They feel that they have no option other than to go along with this nonsense. So these aren't leaders, these are followers. Followers of continuity fear, followers of the ego. So every leader in the world is a follower of the ego. Well, that's okay, because they're not really leaders, they're followers. The real leader, we still have a leader, is the Holy Spirit. So now the cat's out of the bag. We'll see what the Holy Spirit is going to do about it. This is part of my function, is to bring the cat out of the bag, you know, spill the beans. And so then the Holy Spirit can act, you know, and say, well, you know, this was brought to light here in this world. And therefore, this, you know, this is now to correctly counter this, to get around it, sidestep this nonsense, this 15-year plan. Maybe we need a 15-year vacation, actually. How about a 15-year vacation from this world? I'd sign on for that one. Well, another goal, that's everyone in the world repent. Well, just accept the continuity fear, which is repentance. So again, repentance, the first goal is everyone in the world by 15 years from now should be have truly repented and be solidly on the spiritual path to salvation. Let's make that goal number one. Goal number two, everybody in the world turns to the Holy Spirit every day and asks the Holy Spirit to guide their day. How about that? That should probably be number one, 1A. You know, they're all number ones. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. Human, a movie about every single one of us. Is that what they really said that? Is it audacity to say something like that? Human, a new film about every single one of us. Copy by Google right there on the homepage promoting it. Human, a new movie about every single one of us. Really? Every single one of us is human? Is that so? Is that so? Well, maybe we'll find an exception to that here. They should say every single one of us except, we have an exception. And so, of course, they left out the ETs and the hybrids and all that stuff too, but I guess they're lumping that into the flesh. You know, every single one of us is of the flesh. Every single one of us is not what we truly are. We're something different. Great. It's always good to know that Google's on your side. But, okay, so we got the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit's truly our leader. And we asked the Holy Spirit, okay, Holy Spirit, let's have your 15-year plan now. Time to roll it out. So we're on top of this whole situation now. They did not steal a march on us. Just the opposite. We steal the march on them. They're trying to go atomic on us. You know, right? We'll go atomic on them, meaning they're trying to just, full blast. Going atomic means full blast. Oh, and a shock, just a shock, full blast, shock, full blast shock of here we go, this is our 15-year plan, and, you know, this is it. Oh, but we already went atomic on them, full blast. No, Holy Spirit has a plan. Holy Spirit has a plan. And that's a big go plan there. Maybe it's a 15-year vacation plan. I could go for that. Take your early retirement. Time to take early retirement. And, hey, maybe the Holy Spirit has a retirement community for us. You know, don't even need money. You just need right orientation. You need to have repented. That's the coin of that realm. Repentance is the coin of paradise. It's the ticket to paradise, actually. Repentance is the ticket to paradise. So there's another goal. Let's make sure everybody has a ticket to paradise here in 15 years. I mean, what an unbelievable poverty-stricken place this world is, where people don't even have tickets to paradise. That's absolutely crazy. So in our plan, in 15 years, everybody's going to will have a ticket to paradise. They can leave this garbage dump. Let it cool off. I had somebody today, I was standing by my vehicle, and they went past, and they yelled, they said, "Hey, you're in the line of fire." And I said, "Wow, I know, I better get out of here." I don't know why I said that, but he said, "He's yelling at me real loud, you're in the line of fire." The line of fire. Is that the ring of fire? Earthquakes? On the west coast here? I don't know. I finished preparation, gasoline, propane, water. I may get some more water. Barbecues ready in case we have a knockout earthquake at some point here. So thanks to The Guardian, that's a newspaper, internet. I was able to, I Googled the Pope and the UN, addressing the UN, and I think The Guardian gives a lot of facts about stuff, you know. It's, it tells you factually what's going on. I appreciate that. We appreciate it. It says this is the agenda, this is the meeting, this is the schedule, this is what they're doing. Here's a link, check out the video. This is, you know, they just lay it out for you, and you draw your own conclusions. That's true reporting. Actually, this is what's actually helpful. They didn't try to spin it any particular way. I've noticed how The Guardian, they don't tend to spin very much, at least in my experience with it. Which is very limited, but I've noticed at times I've gone, you know, surfed articles over to where on their site, it seems to be, they give good information. I think they're the one that talked about the global police initiative of combating terrorism, that the president's now the chairman and has the authority to create this global police apparatus. They're the ones who reported on that very, very succinctly and clearly, giving the right links, etc. Or you could, you know, research it yourself. So we do have this, again, the most intense, this is the most important week in history. And it's underway. Now, that means the Holy Spirit may do something too this week. Its timing is always very gentle for us. But now that we are aware of this 15-year plan, at least, you know, the ones who are watching this, I am, that means that we're capable of listening to what the Holy Spirit has to say, because it'll put it in context. The Holy Spirit wants us to understand the context of what it's saying. If it just says, "Hey, you need to take a 15-year vacation," we're like, "Oh, what are you talking about? Why are you saying that? It'll scare us." But if it says, "Now you need to take a 15-year vacation," we'll say, "Hey, I understand exactly what you're talking about now. That sounds like a great idea," because it fits, you know, it fits. We understand the context of it. I keep having this song Atomic go through my head. It's going for several days now. Blondie, Atomic, Atomic, Atomic. Atomic, Atomic, Atomic. I don't know what that, why it keeps chirping away like that. Maybe a false flag or something is coming up. Which would certainly then galvanize the global police force, which would then greatly help the global sustainable development initiative plan. You see, this is maybe what they're after. Where they say every country has to cooperate. They want something to get every citizen in the world to think, you know what, hey, we all got to cooperate now on these 17 goals. They already have a plan, but how do they get everybody galvanized to cooperate on it? Maybe a false flag. There's a ton of ideologues in this world that would institute a false flag. Absolutely, they would. The ends to them, the ends justify the means. So to galvanize everybody in the world, get their attention, you know, say, hey, we got to, every single one of us, that's their mantra, every single one of us. But every single one of us has already been saved by the Holy Spirit. And so that's what we need to recognize. That's what's important. That seeing this has to be another one of our all-important goals. And our list is growing, isn't it? I had a dream where we were in this cabin or shed. And a tremendous storm struck, waves, massive waves crashing over the shed. Somehow we survived it all. And then right at the end, some panels popped off and opened up to the atmosphere. And I said, oh my gosh, I gotta fix this, we're gonna be doomed. But it may have been that the storm was over at that point, that's why the panels popped off. Then we could come out of the shed. But boy, that was so intense. Thunderous crashing upon the roof and the walls of the shed by huge waves, extreme winds, etc. And we were thinking any moment we could be crushed, and we never were crushed. We weathered the storm. Yeah. So again, this planet, this world we think is a world. What you see here, the walk stick figure, people walking around, represents spirit in a desperate attempt to completely deny the option of setting pretense down, to completely deny it, to be completely blind and not see it. This is what this world represents. So of course you're going to have extraordinarily bad decisions made in this world in terms of how we spend our time. How we spend our time is all important. So yeah, extraordinarily bad decisions are being made here continuously. And that's the purpose of the world, to make sure that we stay unaware of the option of gently setting aside pretending. Remain unaware of that is possible. To remain completely intimidated by the continuity fear, unaware there's a way to evaporate it. This is the purpose of the world. Keep us so preoccupied, so busy with other goals, that we pay no attention to the true, all-important goal. This is the purpose of the world. And so it's not surprising at all that most are ignorant, blinded to this, to the option that they have. They might hope to find something, but they're so blinded they keep looking in the wrong place. They don't see it. And the steps along the path say, first is, I feel that there's some goal I want to reach, but where is it? I can't find it. I can't find it. The second goal is to pray to find it. Say, oh, I know there's a goal, but I can't find it, but I'm going to pray. Instead of just wandering about I'm going to actually start praying, hey, God, could you please show me the goal? Can you please show me the goal? Third step is to say, I know there's a goal, there's an option that I want with the goal that I want, and I'm going to assert that I have it. I have every right to have it. It does exist, and I have a right to it. It does exist, I have a right to it. It does exist, I have a right to it. Then the fourth stage, you might say, is that I already have the goal. I found it. I found it, and I have it. I found it, and I have it. So another goal, the sustainable development goal, is to make sure everyone's properly educated, has a proper spiritual education, a proper Holy Spirit education. The four basic steps on the path, so everybody's aware of this. So yeah, global education is very important. Every single one of us needs to know this ultimately, because ultimately we do have to set pretense down. So there can be all sorts of diversity of delay involved, but since it's something we all have to do, it's important to educate people about this. In the line of fire, wow. Maybe someone was warning me, hey, this 15-year plan, you're going to be in the line of fire. Better get out of here. I said, yeah, I better go. I'll get out of here right away, and I did. So we won't dwell too long on this. We'll get this out to you. It's very important. It's great information. Just process it, and then we'll go on to the next information. And we'll see what the Holy Spirit has to say about all of this. Okay, very great. That's it.